Welcome again to yet another session of our unique initiative, Lead at WOW. This initiative reflects the vision of Valley of Words, intergenerational dialogue. We're joined by the students of Mount Fort Academy and Hemjyoti, as well as the leadership of two important institutions that have been inspired by Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore, Swami Rama Himalayan University and Vijayan Sen Memorial Kala Kendra. I would like to call upon stage the representative of Swami Rama Himalayan University, Ms. Garima Kapoor. Along with Nicholas Hoffland, representing Vijayan Sen Memorial Kala Kendra, Dehradun. Nicholas Hoffland is a writer, art curator, and design boffin who delights in bending regional cuisines and health food. When not in the kitchen, he can be found sharing his love of jazz, rock, Indian and Western classical music in various forums. Also joining them on stage is the chair for this session, Sri Indu Pandey sir. Sir is a retired senior IAS officer and former chief secretary of Uttarakhand. Renowned for his respected leadership, he is a keen reader and prolific writer who continues to engage with literature and intellectual circles. We welcome you on stage, sir. May I now invite the student moderators to the stage. Let's begin with the students of Mount Fort Academy.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Avantika Dholakhandi and I'm from Mount Fort Academy. On 7 September 2024, I had the opportunity to visit Swami Rama Himalayan University. The purpose of the visit was to explore the campus, learn more about the academic programs, and get a feel for the campus culture. The campus is nestled among tall trees with a blend of modern architecture and traditional brick buildings. The atmosphere was vibrant yet calm, with students walking between classes, some sitting on benches reading, and others gathering in small groups. The campus tour was led by Ms. Garima Ma'am, who made the tour more interesting. During the campus tour, I explored the university's vibrant environment, gaining a first-hand look at its impressive facilities. Garima Ma'am provided valuable insights into the history and culture of the campus, while also highlighting key areas such as academic buildings, libraries, and recreational spaces. By the end of the day, I felt genuinely impressed by everything I had seen. The campus had a great balance of academic rigor and social vibrancy. It was clear that the university values its students and provides plenty of opportunities for both academic and personal growth. I'm excited to see where this journey takes me and hope to be back on campus next year as a student. Thank you. Now, I would request the technical team to kindly play the first video.
Do you ever feel like we are super lucky as we get all the opportunities from our school? I mean, that Mount Fort Academy really prepares us for our lives. It's not just about the academics, but we also get exposed towards the social work, the leadership programs, which many students probably don't get in their schools.
Definitely, our school is one of the best places for that. They really push us to think beyond ourselves and work towards giving back to the community.
Exactly. What I love about our school is that it does not just focus on getting good grades, but also on shaping us into socially responsible people. That's why when you and I visited the Swami Ram Himalayan University, it felt like such a perfect example of what we learn here. Healthcare and education used to truly help the society.
Oh yeah, you guys were telling me about that. What was it like?
It was incredible. Swami Rama Himalayan University is not just another university or hospital. Their focus is on serving people, the healthcare services and education, which was also the goal of Swami Rama.
Now, let me just brief you about our visit thoroughly. I'm sure that your way of thinking will definitely change after we share our experience of the visit to you.
Our visit to Swami Ram Himalayan University and Hospital was more than just an academic outing. It was a profound learning experience that left a lasting impression on each of us. As students of Mountfort Academy, known for its focus on holistic education, we embarked on this journey with high expectations, and the experience exceeded all of them. Accompanied by our English teacher, Ms. Shivani Gupta, a group of 8 of us explored the vast campus under the thoughtful guidance of Ms. Garima Kapoor. The moment we stepped onto the university grounds, we could sense that this was a place where education and compassion were intertwined. Ms. Garima warmly welcomed us and began the educational tour by giving us an overview of the institution. She shared how the university was established under the guidance and vision of Swami Ram, whose dream was to combine modern education and healthcare with a deep sense of social responsibility. One of the most impactful aspects of our visit was learning about the Rural Development Institute, RDI, which serves as the outreach arm of the university. The RDI works to uplift rural communities across the country, providing essential services like healthcare, education, and livelihood training. Mr. Vikesh explained how RDI's initiative have reached over so many villages, touching the lives of more than 100 people. What truly amazed us was the level of dedication shown by the university in offering healthcare to those who need it most. Through RDI, the university brings medical services to remote areas at minimal or no cost, ensuring that even the poorest have access to quality healthcare. The highlights of our visit was the opportunity to meet the Honorable VC, Dr. Rajendra Dobal, and Director General, Dr. V. Chauhan of the university. They spoke to us about Swami Ram's teachings, focusing on the importance of selfless service and the responsibility we have to serve those less fortunate. Listening to their life experiences and their close association with Swami Ram's vision left us all inspired. It was a reminder that true education goes beyond academics. It is about developing empathy, compassion, and a commitment to making the world a better place. I couldn't help but reflect on how this experience aligned with the values of Mountfort Academy. Our school places great emphasis on not just only academic excellence, but also on character development and social responsibility. This visit was a perfect example of what our school stands for, nurturing the students who are not just focused on their personal growth, but also mindful of their roles in the society. Mountfort Academy's curriculum integrates leadership training and community service, all of which came to life during this visit to Swami Ram Himalayan.
Next are the students from Heem Jyoti School. May we have the second video, please?
Go abroad and study in Ramana by the time he did his 10th, he realized that he wanted to do art.
Let's continue with the round of discussion.
Hello. Good afternoon, everyone. Myself Sarthak Pokhriyal, and I am from Mount Fort Academy. So here we are today to ask you some questions about the university. So my first question to you is, in what ways does the university work to instill the principles of Swami Rama of ethical leadership and integrity in students as they prepare for their professional career?
Good afternoon, everyone. First of all, a very warm welcome to this session, and well done, Mount Fort Academy. And thank you, Lead at WOW, for giving us this opportunity to be at this stage. Just to make things in perspective, I am a representative of our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dr. Rajendra Dobal. So pardon me for not giving you that bird's eye view of the queries that you have. I'll try my best nonetheless. So you wanted to ask how we instill the concept of mindful leadership among students. Well, it's a part of the philosophy that we believe in this organization, which is based on Swamiji's vision of love, serve and remember, and also to be of some use to the human all around. We believe in reaching out to people where the institute or the university can't reach. And with those values as base, we try to imbibe the students. Besides learning, they get to participate in activities and interactions with people from all walks of life, all across the globe, so that they get a hint of what these inspirations are, and that they have a duty towards themselves as well as to the society. Thank you.
Good afternoon, sirs, and good afternoon, ma'am. I'm Pooja Dangwal.
And I'm Aditi Nautiyal.
And we are from Himjyoti School. Sir, it is our honor to be able to listen to your views on our curious questions. Sir, we look forward to know more about you as an integral part of Kala Kendra.
पहली बात पूछूंगा, एकदम लास्ट रो में मेरी आवाज आ रही है प्लीज? कूल, थैंक यू. ओके जी, थैंक यू फॉर योर क्वेश्चन एंड थैंक यू फॉर कमिंग ऑल ऑफ यू. इट्स बीन वंडरफुल टू बी हियर इन दिस सनशाइन विद ऑल ऑफ यू. यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट आई एम नॉट हियर अलोन. स्टैंडिंग बिहाइंड मी आर टू पीपल. वन इज दिस एल्डरली जेंटलमैन कॉल्ड डॉक्टर द्विजयन सेन. यू कांट सी हिम, आई कैन. And one is this upright, mustachioed, white-haired person whose name is Colonel Vijay Duggal. They're both here. Okay, and whatever I'm saying are their words, not mine. I am merely a volunteer at Kala Kendra. But having said that, you have to understand a couple of things about Kala Kendra. It was founded in 1949 by one man who had a vision that he alone was sufficient to spread art around wherever he, into whatever he touched. And that was Dr. Dvijayan Sen. He passed away in 2004. And Colonel Duggal took over after that. And at any given time, Kala Kendra has always been, you have to understand one thing, that without craft, there is no art. Kisi bhi cheez ko seekhne ke liye, pehle us cheez ka vyakaran aur us cheez ka anushasan uthana padta hai. Jab wo aapke andar puri tarah ho jayega, saans lete lete aap usko kar paoge, tab kala shuru hoti hai. So the business of teaching people the craft of art and then enabling them to see beyond that, well, that is what Dada did, that is what Colonel Duggal does, that is what Deepshikha ma'am and all the caretakers of Kala Kendra do, and as a volunteer, that is what I do too. Okay, ji?
Thank you, sir, for your answer.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Insha Sharif. So my question is, in what ways does Swami Rama Himalayan University support the personal growth and mindfulness of its students following Swami Rama philosophy?
That's a deep question, but not a difficult one. For anyone who understands Swamiji, as we fondly call him out of regards, you will understand that he could be a saint for some, he could be a mentor to some, he could be a scientist to some. It only depends on how you perceive that one man. And you could have your own perspective to it. But for the larger population, he was a person who was dedicated towards serving the humanity as much as having this. I believe you wouldn't have been born by then, but there was a devastating earthquake in Uttarkashi in 90s. And he went there and we were still part of Uttar Pradesh then, and he made a very strong resolve that unless the people of Garhwal and Kumaon don't get what they deserve, he will go on an undecided fast. That was his commitment towards the society. Well, I'm not promoting a fast or a revolt culture here, but what I'm trying to say is that we try to think of people beyond just ourselves and our needs. For a hospital to function, you could have a simple hospital where a medical care service is provided. But to support that and to promote quality of life, which is another aspect of medical and healthcare, we have Rural Development Institute, like we just saw on the presentation, which goes out to all 13 districts of Uttarakhand, has been serving to almost 2,000 people, villages rather, not just people. And much before the sanitation schemes by Government of India came, we have 14,000 plus individual household toilets. So those are some of the ways where the organization is contributing in community welfare. On the other side, we have sessions time and again where the students are welcome to attend on mindfulness. For instance, as we speak, there is a conference going on, a national conference going on in the institute, where the topic is how to merge spirituality in neuroscience. Well, for many who don't understand these concepts, I don't blame you. But neuroscience takes in its purview neurology, psychiatry, and some more of these mind-related studies. We're trying to see how much that can be imbibed or can be culminated with spirituality. Those are the thought-provoking, rational mindsets we're generating in the university, not just based on any dogma or religious beliefs. We have a very pragmatic, rational approach towards all this. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Sir, my next question to you is that how does Kala Kendra navigate the tension between preserving traditional art forms and innovating within them?
Lovely question. Lovely. Very nice.
Thank you, sir.
Ek cheez samajh lijiye. कला जो है, कोई भी कला होती है जो वो खुद ब खुद जो आप कहे हो, ये जो टेंशन होता है कि मैं इस व्याकरण से, इस डिसिप्लिन से आता हूँ या आती हूँ और मैंने ये सीखा है, लेकिन इसके आगे मुझे बढ़ के मेरा अपना क्या है, मेरी अपनी क्या आवाज़ है, इस व्याकरण के थ्रू मुझे अपना कुछ खड़ा करना है, ये टेंशन प्रत्येक आर्टिस्ट के अंदर होता है और प्रत्येक कला के अंदर होता है। आप हम्पी हालिबेद जाइए, वहाँ पे जो आपको कला दिखेगी, स्कल्पचर्स दिखेंगे, वो उस ज़माने के कलाकार थे, उनको पत्थर तराशना आता था, लेकिन जो कला उन्होंने उस समय खड़ा करी वो पहले कभी देखी नहीं गई थी, और आज भी क्योंकि वो खड़ी है और हमको दिखती है, हमको ये ज़रूर दिखता है कि बहुत ऊंचा लेवल इन लोगों का था। तो ये जो टेंशन होता है कि मैं यहाँ खड़ा हूँ, मेरा परफॉर्मेंस या मेरे आर्ट का इतिहास मेरे पीछे है और मुझे कुछ आगे खड़ा करना है, ये टेंशन प्रत्येक आर्टिस्ट के अंदर होता है, और कोई अच्छा इंस्टीट्यूशन होता है जो आर्ट सिखाता है, ये इस टेंशन को बरकरार रखता है, नर्चर करता है। क्योंकि अगर आप इस तरफ गिर जाओगे कि ये व्याकरण है, मेरे को ऐसे करना है, वैसे करना है, तो यू विल बिकम स्टेल, यू विल नॉट डू एनीथिंग न्यू। ऑन द अदर हैंड, इफ यू जस्ट से मैंने ये करना है या वो करना है, यू माइट सक्सीड, लेकिन अप टू अ पॉइंट। एक व्याकरण के कंधों पे जब आप खड़े होंगे, एक ट्रेडिशन के कंधों पे जब आप खड़े होंगे, आपका नज़ारा जो है थोड़ा और दूर दिखेगा। जब आप पर्वत के ऊपर खड़े हो तो आपका नज़ारा थोड़ा और दूर पहुंचता है, अगर घाटी में खड़े हो तो नज़ारा इतना दूर नहीं पहुंचता है, ठीक है। सो इट्स ऑलवेज बेटर टू स्टैंड ऑन द शोल्डर्स ऑफ सम लर्निंग एंड लुक फॉरवर्ड, बट द इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज टू लुक फॉरवर्ड। If you just go to the peak and sit there, you've just gone to a peak. Looking forward and going forward is the important thing. So, ye jo tension hai ji, if you are an artist, this will be within you. Ye natural cheez hai. Aur ek institute ya institution ka duty ye hota hai ki isko nurture karo aur tez karo. Aur aap mein vyakaran dalo aur aapka nazara bhi jo hai, aur matlab usko badhao. To ye naturally hota hai ji. एक ठीक ठाक आर्ट इंस्टीट्यूशन आपको ये ऑर्गेनिकली करके देगा, अगर नहीं करके दे रहा है देयर इज समथिंग रॉन्ग, एंड आई डोंट थिंक देयर इज एनीथिंग रॉन्ग विद कला केंद्र। ठीक जी,
थैंक यू सर, योर रिस्पांस गिव ऑल द आर्टिस्ट हियर अ डिफरेंट पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ टेंशंस।
सो माय नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर यू इज, हाउ डज द यूनिवर्सिटी मेक श्योर इट्स इंपैक्ट ऑन द सोसाइटी reflects Swami Rama's mission of service?
Again, a very nice question, because there are many students sitting here and they need to know this. For those of them who are interested in healthcare or community health, which falls practically under HIMS, Himalayan Institute of Medical Sciences, and community medicine, that's a different department altogether, which works for community health. So under these departments, for sure, on a regular basis, the students are sent out to health camps and health services. So health camp is basically a concept that we have where the medical fraternity comes out of their regular OPD days and goes out on the farthest of the villages in this state, and they conduct health checkup camps. As far as possible, we do services that can be diagnosed and treated on site. But if it requires anything specialized, they're called down to the institute, and there's a channel working for that, properly identifying them and taking them to the doctor. Along with that, we have some referral services for children with special needs as well. So this is not just done in isolation by the staff and the doctors. The students are also brought on board to participate in it at whatever level they can. So that's one. The other side is, when we conduct these kind of events, we ensure that the students participate in it, not just as an audience, but probably as much as they can in the back end as well. And we have some student-led initiatives as well that take responsibility of organizing these events. Well, of course, when they're organizing, they have mentors, and those mentors are in sync with the philosophy of the organization. So you could say it works like a tradition where it's percolated one person to the other, ensuring that the dignity is not lost anywhere, ensuring that the feel or the philosophy of the organization and the founder is not lost anywhere.
Thank you, ma'am, for your answer.
Sir, my next question to you is, what does a charcoal drawing represent to you personally or artistically?
Oh my. Okay. अब आप स्पेसिफिकली ड्राइंग में आ गए हो, ठीक है. ड्राइंग इज अ डिसिप्लिन, ओके, एंड इट इज अ वेरी बेयर डिसिप्लिन. उसमें आप छुप नहीं सकते हो, ओके, यू कांट हाइड एनीवेयर. इफ यू हैव स्किल यू विल डिस्प्ले स्किल, इफ यू डोंट हैव स्किल इट विल शो. ओके, देयर इज नो वे टू हाइड इन अ ड्राइंग. यू आइदर हैव इट और यू डोंट. The drawing speaks most directly to somebody who's watching it. ठीक है जी. अब आप आते हैं चाकोल में. चाकोल जो है पेंसिल से थोड़ा ज्यादा भारी माध्यम है, ठीक है. उसकी जो लाइन होती है, उसकी जो शेडिंग होती है, उसके डिटेल्स होते हैं, वो थोड़े ब्रॉड स्ट्रोक्स में होते हैं. उसका इम्पैक्ट बिल्कुल अलग होता है. यू कैन इफ यू चूज टू बी more impactful in charcoal. The black and white medium, unless you choose to paint in black and white, stops roughly here, okay? From pencil to charcoal, pencil is the lighter medium, charcoal is the heavier, more impactful medium. You can go to greater scale with charcoal. So charcoal has a lot of possibilities. You can express yourself a lot more strongly with charcoal. बहुत अजीब और सही जगह आप लोगों ने चुनी है फोकस करने के लिए. योर टाइम एट कला केंद्र वॉज वेल स्पेंट. थैंक यू.
थैंक यू सर फॉर योर आंसर. आई थिंक योर आंसर वॉज एज ब्यूटिफुल एज द चारकोल ड्रॉइंग्स दैट वी सॉ एट कला केंद्र.
My next question is, so can you elaborate the partnerships Swami Rama Himalayan University has with like industries and educational institutions, and how does the collaboration benefit the students?
I really wish Doval sir was here to answer you that question, but see, this is one, for instance, where we are meeting on this platform. This is one such association, and there are a couple of more that I am aware of as a team member, but the institute, the university is progressing, and it has made a couple of international associations as well, where we will have student exchange programs in the long run. And besides those international collaborations, there are some which are made with different institutes in the state as well. Like I'm told, we have a couple of agreements with other universities where the students can exchange the programs. And considering that we recently got NAC A+, that enhances our gateway, you could say, enhances our opportunities to go further with those collaborations. So I'm really sorry, I'm not the right person to answer that, but I just know that it's a big time for us, and there'll be more to come. If I do have that answer, I'll let you know personally. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
So my next question to you is, if you could collaborate with a charcoal artist from another era, who would it be and why?
Okay, ji, lovely, lovely, lovely. Okay, now let me give you a word. It comes from another culture. It's called, the word is called kosher, K-O-S-H-E-R. मतलब ये नियमों के हिसाब से स्वीकृत है या नहीं है. That's kosher. So you say, is this kosher? And if it's okay, niyamo ke aadhar pe swikrit, that's kosher. To mera jawab jo hai, aadha kosher hai. Theek hai? In the early 20th century, ek artist the, unka naam tha Egon Schiele. Okay, aap yehi Google jo aapko reels deta hai, yehi Google aapko Egon Schiele ki puri catalog de dega. Okay? तो ईगन शील जो थे उनकी एनाटॉमी का हिसाब नहीं. एक तो होता है कि जी मेरा हाथ थोड़ा भारी बूढ़ा है. ईगन शील जब भी कुछ बनाता था उसको इलोंगेट करके लंबा करके बनाता था. उसका दिमाग जो था कुछ और देखता था और उसका हाथ जो उसका दिमाग देखता था एग्जैक्टली वही बनाता था. देयर इज समथिंग इन आर्ट नोन एज रेजोल्यूशन. हाउ रेजोल्यूट आर यू कि आपने क्या देखा और आपके पास वो क्राफ्ट्समैनशिप है कि एग्जैक्टली जो आपने देखा आपने उतारा. ठीक है, अगर ये विजन और ये आपकी काबिलियत एक लाइन में है, यू आर अ रेजोल्यूट आर्टिस्ट. ईगन शील वॉज अ वेरी रेजोल्यूट आर्टिस्ट. Egon Schiele painted all kinds of stuff, but if you look at Egon Schiele's charcoal work, sublime, fabulous. And the good thing is he loved charcoal too, so he, even when he was painting in oil on paper or anywhere else, he would use charcoal to give himself very strong lines, and he would then very impressionistically fill color. So if I had to go back in time and work with somebody, Egon Schiele's my guy. Okay, ji? Inko Google zarur kijiyega. Sab log, please.
Yes, sir.
You'll learn something.
Thank you so much, sir.
Sir, my next question to you is, how would you describe your sculptures or your arts to somebody who cannot see?
Oh, oh my. Okay, lovely. Ah, such a tough one. एक हमारे लेखक होते थे, उनका नाम था वेद मेहता. उनको भी गूगल कीजिए, अगर आपके लाइब्रेरी में बुक्स हैं तो उनकी किताबें जरूर पढ़िए. वेद मेहता could not see, लेकिन वेद मेहता की जो किताबें हैं इतनी विजुअल हैं, इतनी विजुअल हैं, पूछिए मत. ही विल डिस्क्राइब पीपल्स, मतलब किसी के नाक पे मस्सा है और वो रेलवे स्टेशन में अकेला चल रहा है और बाकी जगह भीड़ है, वो इतना इतना नाजुक डिटेल लिखते थे अपने लेखों में. वेरी डिटेल्ड, फार मोर, अ लॉट मोर डिटेल देन अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल हु कैन सी. नाउ किसी भी चीज को देखने के लिए ना ये वार्ता होती है, डायलॉग. ठीक है, कुछ समय के लिए आप सुनेंगे, कुछ समय के लिए आप बोलेंगे, कुछ समय के लिए सामने वाला बोलेगा और कुछ समय के लिए सामने वाला सुनेगा. इट्स डायलॉग, लिसनिंग एंड स्पीकिंग. सो इफ अ पर्सन हु कैनॉट सी इज क्यूरियस, हर क्वेश्चंस और हिज क्वेश्चंस विल बी हाफ द डायलॉग. What you supply by way of what you can see and how she or he wants to explore, that will establish ki ye hai kya cheez aur unko kya dikh rahi hai. Ye dialogue ki baat hoti hai. Jab aapke teachers aapko kuch sikha rahe hote hain class mein, us samay aapko wo cheez dikh nahi rahi hai. Mathematics ki class mein aapke teachers kya equation ka aakar aapko sikha rahe hain, wo us samay aapko nahi pata. लेकिन आपकी टीचर आपको कुछ बता रही हैं और आप कुछ पूछ रहे हैं और क्लास के अंत में ये इक्वेशन का जो शेप और आकार है वो क्लियर है आपको, आपको दिख गया. उस ही तरह से चाहे स्कल्पचर हो, चाहे पेंटिंग हो, चाहे कुछ भी हो, चाहे कोई अनसाइटेड पर्सन आपके बारे में पूछ रहा हो और मैं आपका वर्णन उनको दे रहा हूँ, वो पूछ पूछ के, हम बता बता के, वो समझ समझ के, हम समझा समझा के आपकी तस्वीर उनके मन में बनेगी. वो मैथमेटिक्स का इक्वेशन आपके मन में बनेगा और चाकोल ड्राइंग हो या स्कल्पचर हो, वो किसी सज्जन को दिखेगा जो नहीं देख सकता है. इट्स अ क्वेश्चन ऑफ व्हाट यू डू एंड व्हाट दे वांट. डायलॉग.
थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू सो मच.
You asked a question about how visually impaired person would understand the sculpture he would work at. I take the liberty to speak that after, as I've been associated in a project for 11 years, working with not just with them but with some others, the sensory part for the visually impaired works with their finger senses. They touch and then they feel. So I think more difficult question would have been, how would a charcoal drawing be interpreted to a person who cannot see? Because sculpture, they would touch, they would feel the texture of the sculpture, and then they can probably cross-check what's the finer line here representing. Everyone has a different texture, everyone has a different facial feature. And, God willing, if we have beautiful sculptures, they will draw all the fine lines. So both of them feel kar payenge, par aap charcoal drawing kaise explain karenge, wo zyada difficult hoga. Am I right?
Ma'am ne bahut sahi kaha. Charcoal drawing बड़ी डेलिकेट और फ्रेजाइल चीज होती है. पहले तो जब आप चाकोल ड्राइंग को कंप्लीट करोगे, पहले आप फिक्सर मारोगे ताकि वो चाकोल झड़ ना जाए. लेकिन वो फिक्सर भी सदा सदा के लिए नहीं होता है, वो भी बड़ा डेलिकेट चीज होता है. तो उसके ऊपर कांच होगा, एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ विच देयर इज नथिंग फॉर द अनसाइटेड पर्सन टू टच, देयर इज ओनली ग्लास. सो जिस प्रकार आप इंटरप्रेट करेंगे कि इसका शेप क्या है, इसकी लाइन विड्थ क्या है, कहाँ रेगुलर कहाँ इरेगुलर, किस तरह का ओवरऑल इम्पैक्ट है, आप क्या देख रहे हो, टेक्निकल डिटेल्स आप देंगे, ओवरऑल उसका जो डिस्क्रिप्शन है आप देंगे, वहीं से उन सज्जन का दृष्टि शुरुआत होगा. व्हाट यू गिव देम इज रियली व्हाट दे विल टेक अवे. जी,
thank you so much sir for your insightful words.
Are you through with your questions? The session I think has been named as initiating Gurudev. Perhaps. Now, who's a guru? Guru means one who's dispeller of darkness. Darkness is darkness of ignorance, and which is replaced by the guru, by the light of knowledge. That brings us to a question, what is knowledge? You may have heard of Socrates. Have you heard of Socrates? Have you heard of Plato? Plato was a great Greek philosopher. His guru was Socrates, another Greek philosopher, first among the lines of great Greek philosophers. So once, and the method Socrates used to follow was the method of dialogues with his disciples. So he told his disciples that the only thing I know of is that I know nothing. So all the disciples were wondering कि हमारे गुरु जो सबसे ज़्यादा ज्ञानी हैं, वो ये कहते हैं कि साहब मुझे तो कुछ नहीं आता है. तो दे सेड, अगर आपको कुछ नहीं आता तो हम लोग किस लाइन में हैं? तो ही सेड, देयर इज सो मच ऑफ नॉलेज, नॉलेज इज इनफाइनाइट, आई नो अ वेरी लिटिल पार्ट ऑफ इट. सो वी हैव टू कंटिन्यूसली मेक एफर्ट्स टू नो एज मच एज वी कैन. वी टॉक्ड अबाउट गुरुदेव रवीन्द्रनाथ टैगोर. He has written that I love India not because I love the idolatry of its geography, कि मुझे इसके भूगोल से बहुत ज़्यादा वो नहीं है, और not because I have had the privilege of being born on its soil. I love it because the words which emanated from its scholars and which have stood the test of tumultuous times, Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma. This is a verse from Taittiriya Upanishad. Upanishads are the philosophical part of the Vedic literature. तो उनका सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम ब्रह्म, सत्य जो है उसमें और ज्ञान में कोई अंतर नहीं है, और ये अनंत है, दिस इज इनफाइनाइट. नाउ वी कैन नेवर विजुअलाइज द इनफाइनाइट, वी कैन जस्ट लाइक जीरो, वी टॉक ऑफ जीरो एंड इनफाइनाइट इन मैथमेटिकल इक्वेशंस, बट रियली इफ समबडी सेज थिंक इन इनफाइनाइट टर्म्स, there the thought gives up, it raises its arms, it's beyond intellect. So these are issues. Ma'am referred to neuroscience. There was one great neurosurgeon, Sir John Eccles, who was a Nobel laureate. He met another physics, particle physics expert in a golf, on the golf ground, or perhaps in a ski resort somewhere in the Alps region. And both of them started discussing about neuroscience and physics. They said there are certain things which are beyond our domain, beyond the domain of neuroscience and beyond the domain of science. There are two views. One is called the view of scientism or scientific optimism, that someday we'll discover everything. The other view is, no, there is a large domain which is beyond that, and therefore we have to strive for knowledge all through our life. You have very interesting questions and very equally interesting answers also. I think the question about how do you narrate to the blind sculpture. So as Mr. Nicholas said, samvad hai, it's a dialogue. Everything is a dialogue. Recently I was reading Noam Chomsky has just lost his voice. Yet before that there was a great physicist, Stephen Hawking, who was virtually paralyzed. But he is the person whose discoveries, whose philosophical ideas, whose scientific ideas are very, very relevant today. So has been the case with Noam Chomsky. So there are various forms in which dialogue can be established. It is not only visual. That's why we say all you have to have is a curiosity. We call it perceptual curiosity, that things you perceive, you try to know about it. The other is called epistemic curiosity. Epistemology is about knowledge, the theory of knowledge. So you should have a curiosity for knowledge. And I'm very glad that both of you, and of course your colleagues also, must have, and this is the part of education. Education is successful if this can cultivate a sense of curiosity in you, the sense to know things. And as Mr. Nicholas said, there is no end. It is infinite. You go beyond the summit. And I congratulate you all. I congratulate both of my colleagues here that it has been a very interesting session, and you will continue to indulge into this. Thank you very much. Thank you, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, put your hands together for our participants. Can I have on stage the teacher in charge, the nodal officers, and the students of Mount Fort Academy? I would like to request the chair of the session, Sri Indu Pandey sir, to felicitate the teachers, the students, and the nodal officers. Next, I would like to request the students of Hemjyoti School, along with their teacher in charge and nodal officers, to please come upon the stage. A round of applause for them. I would like to request our chair to please felicitate the directors. Thank you all.